Hello everyone, thanks for checking in. My name is Howard and I'm going to be showing you how to use the SR-303 Pioneer Reverb unit to have the sound come through your receiver. I'm going to give a little demonstration on how to throw the switches, where they need position they need to be in on the receiver and the reverb unit. Right here on the receiver and the monitor switch, it is in position one right now. Right here, it's in number one. On the reverb unit, I have the engage for the reverb to be on. The monitor switch is pushed in. And now I'm going to turn on some music here. These are the positions that on both units that has to be engaged. I'm going to turn on some music here so we can see this little symbol here, the inside the little glass unit, the blue and the little green circle there that will start flashing once we turn up more of the depth on the unit. Okay. There we are. The little light is blinking inside the glass there. If I shut off the reverb unit here, I'm hit the off button. No reverb is going through, just the music. Turn it back on. There it is flashing again. I'm going to turn this up a little bit. I'm going to stop talking. Hopefully you can hear how crazy it gets once I turn up the music and turn up the depth on the reverb unit. So hopefully you can hear that. That's what happens when you max out the depth on the reverb unit. I'll back it back down. And that's where everything needs to be. Your monitor switch on your receiver needs to be in position one. Engage the reverb unit to on. And your monitor switch, make sure the red light is on. I'm going to show you how to also use the duplicate switch. I'll go and kill the music. Now to use this duplicate switch on the receiver, you can throw this switch all the way down and it says 2-1. Monitor switch is going to stay in the one position. On the reverb unit, here on the right-hand side, we're going to shut off the monitor switch. The red light goes out. And we're going to push in the record button. The one in the middle says record. Now we're going to turn on a second source from the first one, and we're going to play some music on this one. And there we go. And that's all you have to do to that. Nothing else. If I flip the switch, just knocked over my camera. There we go. If I flip the switch back up, you will lose the sound. There you go. That's what happens if you take it off 2-to-1 on the duplicate switch. Push it back down. Just like that. So that's all you have to do to use that reverb unit. It took me a long time to figure out the wiring diagram to get this to work. And anything that I run through this receiver, the signal will go through that reverb, and I will have reverb no matter what I'm using. If I use the auxiliary, same way. I can get reverb from my CD player. If I put an MP3 player to the receiver, all the sound, music will go through this reverb, and I will get reverb no matter what I hook up to it. So I hope this helps you. Anybody that's wanting to figure out how to get your sound to come through your receiver. Like I said, it took me a long time to figure this out, all the wiring. I hate to pull this back out and try to give you which way to hook it up, because there's a lot of wires back behind there. So thanks for tuning in. If you like this channel, please subscribe. I'm out of here.